want to play croquet?
Okay.
Come on, honey. Jump. Jump, 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 jump. Up, 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 up.
This is the most curious croquet ground I've ever seen in all my life.
Jump, darling, jump, jump.
It's all ridges and furrows.
I said jump.
Jump.
The croquet balls are live hedgehogs. And the croquet mallets are live flamingos.
You too, darling. Off with our head, I admit.
The chief difficulty seems to be in managing the flamingo. So... once you get it, tucked away comfortably enough under the arm, with the legs hanging down, and once you get its neck nicely straightened out, and you're going to give the hedgehog a blow with its head. It looks up in your face and gives you such a puzzled expression that everyone bursts out laughing. I've come to the conclusion it's a very difficult game indeed.
Oh, never play croquet with the ball that's a hedgehog. Hedgehog will run away. Never hit a hedgehog with the beak of a flamingo. That's not how to play croquet. You'll be stuck with your book in the mug and your beastug. Y'all help me.
You'll be stuck with your book in the mug and you'll be stuck.
Never play croquet with a ball that's a hedgehog, cause a hedgehog will run away. Never hit a hedgehog with the beak of a flamingo, cause that's not how to play croquet.
You'll be stuck with your book in the mug and you'll be stuck, you know.
You'll be stuck with your book in the mug and you'll be stuck.
I see lots of hedgehogs running. I see lots of flamingos sunning themselves in this tropical air. It isn't fair.
It's my turn now. Never play croquet with the ball that's a hedgehog, cause the hedgehog will run away. Never hit a hedgehog with the beak of a flamingo.
They play it all fairly.
Yeah.